So you can just observe I have three division tags within the main container. So the yellow color is the main container. Within that I have three division tags. I have assigned different style to each of those division tags. So now we'll just work with this three elements, and also we'll follow the position, whatever the different types we have discussed. By default, okay, the method is static. Even if you don't specify, by default it is static, and also the content, it is going in the normal flow, that is in terms of block level. Okay, so if you want to make it a display property, so you need to set that. I will just show you. I don't want to use this display here. Inline, if you want to make inline all the elements, all the blocks, actually you should complete. It has to move to the up when I specify inline block. Oh, it is not changing. Okay, you can just observe. Okay, I am just telling each of the elements, not the parent element. Within the parent element, I need to tell. So, instead of normal flow, go with the inline. Okay, inline means it is changing the normal flow. Always the division tag is the block level. Always by default, it will take to the new line. So now, because of this property, so all the elements are displayed in the form of inline. Okay, so I'll just, I don't want to use this as of now here. If you want, you can just use. I will just remove these. There are so many properties and values. You need to just go through and you have to check how exactly it is changing. I think till here, everybody understood, no? So main program, nothing I have done. Only with respect to the styles. So now we'll just go with applying the position. Okay, the position property, whatever we have discussed, by default it is static. Once again, it does not require to show the static. If you want, let me just try that also. I will just I am just going to apply the position, okay, to make it difference between the other elements. I'll just work with this blue color box. Okay, I will apply the different position and we will see how exactly this element is positioned. Okay, so your position, you can just see there is nothing changes in the browser. Okay, this part is the browser part, view part. So you cannot see any changes. That means by default the position is a relative. Even if you give left, left, or it should move. Okay, if I give 50 a pixel. Okay, there is nothing changes. It is not changing anything. So now if you want to place these block at a specified position, so then we have to go for the different other types of the CSS positioning type. So the first one is done. Next we'll move on to a relative. Okay, so what is this relative tell? So before going to the relative, yesterday I was explaining, okay, how you want to move the elements. So if you want to move the elements outside the container, okay, or the browser view part, so accordingly you have to give the values. If it is within the margin, whatever it is specified, you will be normally giving positive values. If you want to give outside, if you want to move the element out of the container, you will give the negative element. If you want, you can just observe. So if you specify static, it won't work. So now let me first go with the relative. What relative property tells? What is the relative property tells? So you can move the element however you want. Okay, either top, left, right. And here the position is going to take from its location, from its normal flow. Okay, if I tell left move 50 pixels. So from its position, it is going to move 50 pixels. Okay, if you want to move top, from its position, it will move top 50 pixel like that. Okay, and also whatever the space it is going to create, it is not going to be occupied by any other element. It will be left, the gap is left as it is. So that is in case of relative. So we can just check that here. So relative. So I will just specify move left 100. Excel. Okay, did you observe the output? Try to observe. So as and when I do, I am doing here, immediately you can see the output. Okay, so if the element is moved left 50 pixels from its position, okay, from its position the element is moved left 100 pixels. If you want to move top, taking so much of time to reflect the, okay, I need to here specify pixel. Okay, you can just say it is going out of the container. So this is the 50 pixel from its normal flow. It is not taking from here, from the main container. When you specify relative from its flow, okay, this is the flow for this particular element. Okay, from there it is moving 50 pixel right side. Okay, similarly, let me just move the element. Left with the 250. Okay, can you observe what has happened? I am just moving left side, okay, from its position 250 pixel. And also you can just see here the whatever the space or the gap is created, okay, that is left as it is. It is not going to change the flow of the content when you specify position is relative. Okay, is it clear about the relative? That's all about the relative. So next, let me move on to any doubt. Any doubt with respect to relative? Just remember, it will move the element from its position, okay, from its normal flow. And also whatever the space or the gap that is created, it is not going to disturb. It will be left as it is. Okay, it will not change the flow of the content after moving the element. So now we'll just check with the absolute. Did you observe what happened when I specify the position? So the load 250 pixel away from its normal flow. And also here you can just observe. So here whatever the space it is created by this element, okay, so that is occupied by the other element. Okay, it is going to change the normal flow of the document if it is any space is created. When you specify position absolute, okay, whatever the gap it is created, that is occupied by the other element. So that is the main difference between the absolute and float. Understood everyone? Absolute and relative. No responses only. Okay. Next, what is the next method we have? Absolute is over. So next we'll move on to fixed. I want to fix the element at some particular position. Okay, so fixed. To make you better understand, I will locate this element at some part of corner. Okay, so that is bottom. So here it is bottom at the left. I want to make it to right. So normally if you want to work with any of the, like any of the website, normally you will be having one chart box at the corner, right side corner. Okay, so like that we'll just, if you do spelling mistake, so this editor is not identifying. Okay, if you use Sublime, so normally you will get the pop-up, okay, the list of elements with respect to that. When you are doing this using this editor, you just be cautious with respect to spelling mistake. Okay, did you observe? So now this element, and it is going to be fixed even if you do scrolling and all. Okay, so the location of this element is fixed. Are you people are observing? Okay, you can just observe the element is moved only here, that is the bottom right. But one thing you observe, this is within the container. If you want to make, normally you just observe any of the web pages, okay, you will be having chart box, chart with a something like that. Okay, normally it is placed at the bottom right side. So that, for such purpose you can use it. And also this position, it is going to be fixed even if you do scrolling and all. So this will be fixed, it is not going to move. Okay, so now this is done with respect to the this main container or the parent element. If you want to make it with respect to the browser, so you have to add the position here. Did you observe as soon as I wrote relative? Okay, so the element is moving from the main parent element. Okay, so your parent element is relative and it is not considering this container from there. Okay, before it was, when I not specified the position, so this was the bottom right. So now when I wrote position relative, it is going to consider the main container. So the browser is the main container, so accordingly it is moving to that particular position. Okay, so just minimize, you can just view that part. Okay, so if I, you just observe, if I remove this, so this is how the static method works. So if you want to make it fixed, normally you will use the position fixed. If you want to make element to that particular location to be fixed, so we'll use it using the method fixed. So next we'll move on to, okay, so next we'll move on to the another method called sticky. Okay, so what is this sticky tells? I will just add some more part of the code so that you will come to know how it can be done. So here I will use navigation tag. I have just created the navigation tag. Okay, nothing, just it will create a list containing navigation elements, that is home, contact us, about. So here I have given for this navigation, I want to apply some of the styles. So for that I have used the class ST. Now we'll just write a CSS for that. Okay, this part is done. Whatever the four methods I've explained, so now I'm explaining about the fifth method. So now go here. So this is class, start with ST. ST, whatever I have given, ST. Okay, so now write the code. What do you want to make? So if you want to make, change the color for this navigation part, so I'm just going to apply background color. So I got the purple color here, or if you want any other color, you can just try and do it. So now I want to make this, okay, say when I scroll, even this whatever the navigation we have created, that is also going, it is scrolling, okay, along with the scroller. So now I want to make this particular navigation bar should be stick on to, even if I scroll, it should be stick on here at the top. Okay, so for that you have to use the, okay, so here only you can write position sticky. Just observe, still no changes. You have to specify the what should be the position to stick. Okay, I will give top 0 pixel goes to this particular part. Okay, automatically it is going to stick to that particular top 0. So wherever you want, you can just give that value here. If you want to make it 50, so when it reaches position 50, okay, so it is going to be sticky there. It is not going to scroll. Even if you scroll it, it will be there. It is mainly used for navigation purpose. So this is all about the different types of CSS positioning types. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, we can go to the next topic. Hope everybody understood this part. Okay, the textbook they have given with some paragraph and image, so you can just try this part also. Okay, so I need to specify about the Z index. Yesterday I was explaining about the Z index. So Z index, it is mainly used for stacking the elements. Okay, so we are going to use this element Z index property to stack the elements. So how to stack the elements? Let's check. I told, whenever if you are specifying Z index property and if you specify some number, okay, if you have three blocks, for three blocks, if you have given some number, whichever the block that is having higher number, that is going to highlight. Okay, it will come front and the other will be going back. The content will be displayed at the back. So let me just write a code for that. So you need to change all this. We'll just change the position. Okay, position of this element. Now I'll just remove this sticky part. So now go back to, okay, so left 50 pixel I have given. Okay, don't give left, don't go with the right, go with the left. If you go with the right, what happens is the element will be moved out. Okay, so now I made these two elements overlap. Similarly, let me go with the third element. Okay, so here what you have to do is, with the bottom, I'm just trying to place this element at the appropriate place. Okay, so will you see these elements are like stacked one by one? Okay, so now which one you want to highlight? Okay, so what is the order in which you want to display the element? So each positioned element has stacking order defined the z index property. Okay, so now let's do how to do the stacking, how you can give the prioritize the stacking for each of this element. So you, if you want to make, you can just observe now green color is backside. Okay, it is like the priority is given lower than this blue color. So let me just first increase this. Okay, and I want to move little more left side. Okay, you can just observe. So which one you, if you want to make green color the high prioritized, then you go to that item, right, property, z. Code is visible now. So here you write index colon. I will just you have to give the number. That's all. Okay, 50. Okay, I have just taken item 2. That's why you did you observe what happened? Let me just change this. Okay, so you can just see the order currently. The priority is red, blue, green. Okay, let me just change to reverse. So I will go with first third index for the item 1. I will give more priority for this. Let it be 50. Then did you observe the changes you observe? Then I will give year 49. And this one I will give 48. Okay. So the lower the value, lower the priority. That's all. Did you observe? So now I will change the order, stacking order. So this is another method of specifying the position using assert index. Okay, understood everyone? Okay, in the textbook they have given with the image and image caption. You can just use that also. So yes, this important is the syntax. Okay, how you are going to work with these properties. So any queries as of now? So that is mainly used for stacking purpose. So next we'll move on to, so that's all about the CSS positioning. If they ask CSS positioning different types, you need to explain these. Okay, you have wherever it is necessary, you have to write a code. Okay, you have to write the code. If you want to specify these methods, if they ask, you need to write a small HTML, whatever I have created here. Okay, like this. It's a very small piece of code, HTML code. For that, you will be writing this CSS property. And you have to explain so how each of these methods are working. So next we'll move on to the next topic called floating elements. Okay, so what is this floating element, how we can use when we are designing the web pages? So floating elements, it is possible to display an element out of its position in the normal flow via CSS float property. Okay, so normally we have discussed till now the normal flow, whatever the predefined tag you are using, either block level or inline, accordingly, so it is going to position the elements in the web page. If you want to change the position of the normal flow, okay, so if you want to change the position of normal flow, one we have already discussed using position. So using position also, you can change the position of the element away from the normal flow. So here another method we have called CSS float property. Okay, so this is a property. Using this property, you can change the position. So what exactly it is going? I think in maybe in the CSS basic class, I have explained about this float property, not in detail. So here I'll be explaining in detail. So it means to far left or to far right of its containing block. Okay, in whichever the block the element is represented. So either you can move a left or a right. The rest of the content is reflowed. Okay, whatever the content it was there after moving, it is going to go back and it will occupy the space that is created around the floated element. So maybe I have an example, you can just observe. So this is the content. Normally, so this is our actual page when you create a document like this. So this will be the result of that document. So now in case if you want to make this image and around this image the elements should be displayed. So in such cases we'll be using the property called float. Okay, so accordingly you can specify. So if you want to make the floating of this element either लेफ्ट साइड, राइट साइड, ओके, एंड ऑल्सो ऑटोमेटिकली द कंटेंट विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग द स्पेस दैट इज क्रिएटेड, ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड रीफ्लो. सो द कंटेंट विल बी रीफ्लो टू अकॉर्डिंग टू द पोजिशन वॉट एवर यू आर स्पेसिफाइड. सो आई विल जस्ट शो यू वन एग्जाम्पल फॉर दिस. So this is more with respect to the container, okay? So whatever I explained, that is only with respect to the just the value right and left. So let me just show you the output of that, then later I will go to the okay, you can just observe I have some content here and there is one image. So now what I'll do is I will just go with the float property. Okay. So you can just observe just a small piece of code, and I have just given some coding part with respect to the image. So now you need to specify where exactly the image should get float. So let me just try with the first float type. The property value will give left. Okay, save it and refresh this content. Okay, did you observe? So the image is moved left, and also the content it is reflowed. Similarly, if you want to change to right side, I'm just moving this image to right side and the content should follow accordingly. Okay, so this is how you can just make use of the float property to rearrange the elements within the web page. This is directly not exact location, this is directly the specified either left or right. So what are the other options we have? Let me just go through in brief. So float will help to move left or right of its container. Okay, so you can just move left or right from its container. It is also called container block in the FO figure. I think the same example I have already given. So in case if you are applying floating, okay, so where the elements is having margins, okay, margin if it is specified, so if you want to use collapse option, it won't, you cannot use the collapse option. Okay, that is one thing you need to remember. Okay, so margin do not collapse on floated block elements. When you apply for each block, so here whatever the example I have shown, I have not given any styling in terms of border margin. If you apply, you can just observe, if you specify float property for that particular element, okay, so it is not going to collapse the margins. You can just clearly, you can just observe the different colors of the block. Okay, and if you want to float multiple items side by side, you can just try this piece of code by yourself. Okay, so take more like 7 to 8 images and some content. Okay, and just use float property. Just check it how exactly the flow of the element is going to change. Okay, so here these are the different. Okay, this is about the float. So next we have clear property. Okay, so similar to float, we have clear property. For this I have not created any program. Okay, so let me just show you this clear property in tomorrow's class. Okay, so just today you work with the positioning element and also float. So tomorrow I will explain with the clear, and also we have overflow. Overflow is already thought. Once I have explained about the overflow, all its possible values. Okay, I want you people to go through this. If you want to hide the element, how you can make use of overflow. Okay, so that's all about the. So someone, you just go through this. That is overflow and also clear. If you want clear, I will just show you the difference. Okay, how clear you can use it to move the elements at a specified position. So I want you people to go through the overflow and hiding the elements.